Hello there, my name is Dominic and today I'm going to show you how to eliminate that annoying thumping or popping sound that happens on your speakers through your amplifier when you turn it off. Let me demonstrate. This is the TPA31162D amplifier chip presented in this small circuit that I bought on AliExpress. This thing works very fine. Actually, it can drive these two speakers very well, and the output, I just love it. But it has this one very annoying problem, and that is when I turn it off. Let me turn off the power here. It makes that annoying sound. Now, that annoying thump or popping sound comes from a sudden surge of current from the output stage of the amplifier going through the voice coil of the speakers. And by the way, that thing can destroy the speakers. And now it's time to solve this problem once and for all. Although this is just a proof of concept video, let me show you how I solved this problem using a relay. Someone on the internet recommended placing a capacitor on the output stage of the amplifier, but unfortunately that didn't work. This is what worked for me. This is a simple 12 volt relay. This is the setup that I currently have. You can connect a voltage of between 12 to 26 volts to this amplifier. At the moment, I'm using this 12 volt adapter, and that goes well with my 12 volt relay. With this setup, I'm getting that annoying popping sound, but once I introduce this relay to the output stage of the speaker, that popping sound will go away. The relay has four legs, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Two of the legs are connected directly to the coil inside, and two of the legs are the output. Now, when you energize this coil, it will create a magnetic field that will attract this thing, so it connects between these two things. So this is just a switch, an electronically controlled switch. In our case, this is what we are going to do. Disconnect one of the cables here and connect it across the relay. Now, in theory, when I turn off the power to the relay will be de-energized, and that will disconnect over here, and we won't get that annoying bumping sound. Before I go on, you will notice that I have a diode here. This is called a freewheeling diode. It's usually placed across the terminals of the coil in an opposite manner, because when it de-energizes, it induces the current in an opposite manner. So when it does that, it's just going to loop it around just like that. And I've done this to protect the amplifier from negative voltages when this thing de-energizes. I've already connected it across the power supply. Like I said, this is the 12 volt power supply. And now I just need to disconnect one of the speaker cables and connect it to the output stage, just like that. And the other end I will connect to the output speaker terminal. Before I go on, I'm just making this video as an entertainment piece only, because I'm dealing with electronics and electricity here. There is a very high risk of electrocution, burning down your house or your electronics, so beware. Please take your project to a certified and trained technician so that he can handle everything for you. Without the speaker connected, let's hear the relay clicking when I turn on the power. I'm sure you heard the relay clicking, so that means that it's working. If I connect the speaker, let's see if that thumping sound has reduced. And now I'll turn on the amplifier and then turn it off. So the sound is still there. And I believe it's because of all the capacitors inside the power supply as well as on the amplifier circuit. And this charge in the capacitors is just enough to keep the relay energized as well as pass through to the speakers. The next thing that I'm going to try is an external power supply. And for that, I have this transformer. This is a 10 volt transformer. Now, instead of powering the relay through the power supply that is also powering the amplifier, I will use this transformer externally. That is the transformer, 240 volts. Like I said, very dangerous, can electrocute you. But the output is 10 volts that I will pass through a single diode and into our relay. Let's try that. And now I will power it on. So that is not good. To solve that problem, I'll just introduce a capacitor here. but intentionally I will use a low value capacitor, and I've chosen 16 volts by 47 microfarads. With the transformer plugged in, you can see that the output voltage is 10.8 volts. And now let's measure the continuity of the output stage. That is connected. And now I will connect the whole circuit together and see if that annoying popping or thumping sound has disappeared forever. The music is playing fine. And now if I turn off the power, you can see there is no thumping annoying sound at the output stage. So this is my solution, a very simple method that I can replicate on a strip board. Now with a separate power supply, I can now connect the amplifier to a 19 or 24 volt power supply so that I can get even better powerful output from the speakers. Now let me address some concerns that some of you might have had. And one of them might be a method to discharge the capacitors much faster. Believe me, I've tried everything. These capacitors will just keep energizing that coil, and that will just create that thumping sound at the end. Another concern might be, I've only done this for a single speaker. What about the other speaker? Well, this was just a proof of concept. This relay was from a microwave oven, and you can see the output stage is meant for AC. 3 ampere, 250 volts. And at the top there, you can see the coil needs 12 volts DC. Now there are relays out there with two separate switches, and that's what you can use. A single power supply, one relay with two outputs that you can use for both the right and left channels. And the last concern, this seems like a very stupid power supply. I know it is. This was a proof of concept. In the future, I'm going to build a full bridge rectifier. Now from the corner of your eye, you might have noticed this IC. This is a burnt audio IC, and this belongs to this hi-fi. This is an LG hi-fi. Very old, with a discontinued motherboard. You can see all those tracks over there missing. Very unfortunate. Now the purpose for me buying this amplifier was to install it inside here so that we can get good audio output. I also traced some things. You can even see I have this wire that I would have just installed it inside here and fix this radio once and for all. But I hit a problem, and that's because I can't get a good enough signal from this thing. I don't know what the problem is. Maybe I'll try and fix it. I think the problem might be the power supply. I'll try and fix it, and maybe in the future you can see that video. So that's it. I hope you learned something new today. Please like, subscribe, and comment. Share this video with your friends. Let's meet in the next video, and goodbye.